Hello, everybody, and welcome to sort of like a one-off intermission kind of thing, introduction, whatever you want to call it. So, a few things first, just because I've completely forgotten to mention in both of these survival videos I recorded that I managed to max all the characters' abilities apart from Nancy's. I mean, I'm getting there. Slowly. Slowly, it's getting there. I'm also getting used to her ability. It's a little bit weird, confusing, but I'm getting used to it. Not as much as, everyone else is, but I'm getting there. Slowly. It's a slowly learning process for me, but overall, it is what it is. Speaking of which, we also got weapon skins, and this may be a hot take coming from me, or this is just, this is my opinion. And I pretty much find them a little bit underwhelming. They could have been way more better, but in my opinion, it's a bit underwhelming. So, yeah. As for the kills, the new kills we got, I definitely would say the most brutal ones are Leatherface, Cook, Hitchhiker, and Johnny. Sissy's new kill was pretty okay. However, Nancy's kill is a little bit, it could have been a way more better, But overall, I just find it a little bit, it's an underwhelm. I think other two are pretty much more better-ish. A little bit slow, but a little bit better. I definitely will say her close encounter win is way more better kill than the new kill that she's gotten, but that's just my opinion. Overall, yeah, so that's that. And also, before I end off again, mention we also got free cosmetics for Sissy, the Glide cosmetic, and the Shirtless Johnny cosmetic. No, you don't have to pay for it. It's completely for free, and that's kind of nice that we don't have to pay extra money for a Shirtless Johnny and a Glide cosmetic. So it's kind of nice for them to give us free cosmetics. Yeah, for Sissy and Johnny. So, yeah. It is what it is. I'll take that as a win. But regardless, I'm pretty sure that's enough of me rambling, talking about my certain opinions about certain things that we got with the, update. But, it is what it is. I'm not too, bothered by it. I'm just like, there's certain things that could be improved, but, yeah. But, I'm pretty sure you had enough of this introduction, and enough of that said, let's get right into the matches and let's get this video started. I hope you enjoy. Well, that doesn't sound good. Why, hello everybody, and welcome back to some more TCM. How's everyone doing? Did you all enjoy your weekend?
I should keep this, just in case. Oh, yes, a shortcut.
My weekend was pretty good.
Is this human?
Oh, no toolbox. Oh.
I can use that. Danny, look this way.
Okay, that'll do it. Oh, I'd recognize this.
Oh, it's just poisoning in one of the traps. Yeah, for the longest time, I didn't think you could do that when you're playing this. Poisoning. You're trying to get the shots. But when I found out, I was like, fair enough. You learn something new every day. Sorry, Chaka. I'm gonna get hit here. Yeah.
Nasty. This will help.
Oh, someone announces. Weld.
I think this is antiseptic. Should clean the wound.
All this blood. They got trouble
right
now.
Here. Connie.
Oh.
Here. No, they're bad. Stay quiet.
Oh, for... yeah, they have faces on this way as well. Or maybe not. I did see him, like, literally near the gate. I was just like, oh boy.
Please, please.
That was intense.
How many are there? Come on.
I got it. Oh, hey, Draco. On to the next match. They were doing well, keeping pressure on the battery. I think that's meant to be Anna OP. Someone on lines like that. Yeah, like the OP survivor. Like the best survivor in the in game. Which, I mean, yeah, she can take like insane amount of damage, especially from Leatherface. If you're thinking of other survivors like Connie or Danny, then I would say no. If I had to rank her with all the survivors, I'd probably put her in number 3. I'd put Danny at 1 and Connie at 2. So I probably would say that she's like 3rd best, in my opinion. But then again, yeah, a lot of people will probably put, you know, Leland over. I know, but I could be wrong. Oh, I've been marked. I moved a little bit too soon.
Right here.
Oh, someone's walked into Nanta's trap. I'm gonna take it, that's it, Chico. Or Nanta removing her one of the traps. Oh, it's daytime this time. Interesting. All right, you do it then.
Okay.
You probably heard that as well. Sorry, Bubba. No hard feelings.
This go.
Oh.
Damn it.
Seems safe enough.
Right, I need to heal.
Exactly,
you think you're going. I'm sorry, Nancy. I saw the door close on me, and I saw her door close the door on me, and I was just like, I might as well do the shortest action. Because it takes them like 8 seconds to recover. It was either that. Or try for the bat route again. Playing as Wayland again.
The search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth leads. Family and friends are urging...
Hey, it's another old Bubba.
Wait, can I use that?
It's got a zoom in there. Yeah. Well, that is not good. I don't know whether he's just saying that or not. Because if she is cheating, I wouldn't have been able to shoulder tackle her. Oh, for fuck's sake. Well, I got my hat trick. got my three escapes in a row. Yeah, it's just gonna bleed out. Damn. I don't usually report people, but I mean, come on, there's no need to swear over a perk. The thing is, a perk's a perk, and I don't really do grapples that often. I tend to save it, but even when I do use it, at the end of the day, I only can use the bone shards like twice, and that's it. And then it's pretty much useless. So I don't know what the problem is. But I have a funny feeling that it will probably end up getting nerfed at some point. Because, like, it's an instant win. And I can see why a lot of family members have an issue with it, because like I said, it's an instant win for the only two survivors you can get it on is Leland and Annan. You can't get it on Connie, you can't get it on Sonny, you can't get it on Julie, you can't get it on Danny, you only can get it on two survivors. So, you know, I don't know what the problem is with that perk, but like I said, I have a funny feeling that perk will eventually get nerfed in the end, because, yeah, like I said, it's an instant win. Yeah, but, yeah, there are times where I've actually lost with the perk. There have been times where I've actually lost with Grappler, because I have been on low on health, or someone else was in the area, and it was due to my poor timing of, you know, doing a grapple with another family member, and I'm like, oh, yeah, GG's, I'm not mad about it, yeah, if I lose, and I'm like, eh, you know, it is what it is, but it's like Dead by Daylight all over again, people get mad at, oh, you're running barbecue chili, oh, you're running this, you're running that. You mean, at the end of the day, who cares? It's a perk. Get over, you know, get used to it. If you don't like it, tough. Yeah. End of story. At the end of the day, it's just a game. Don't take it personally over a perk. Just move on to the next match. I mean, we all have our bad matches. We all have a good matches. We all have a mixed matches. But, yeah. Like I said, yeah, I don't like, you know, use that perk to literally do an Instagram like every 5 seconds. I only do it if... you know, just to, you know, give me time to escape. Yeah, so like a second chance kind of thing, just in case if I use my shoulder tackle. Yeah, at some point in the game, and if I get it back, I tend to use my shoulder tackle first before I use a grappler. Yeah, I tend to save them when it really matters. But if I'm like, say for example, if Grandpa was fully maxed, and if I have all three members chasing me, then that probably will be a different story. because I will not use grappler because I will have no chance of a, of a break because of continuously, hunt me down. Right, then I think not. Yeah, regardless. Yeah, I don't think that Sissy was cheating. I think he was just mad at the fact that he was killed. Oh, she was killed. Yeah, so then, getting certain salt in the chat just because you died, you just immediately think, oh, yeah, they're hacking, even though you can do a thing. And like I said, even they were hacking, I doubt that that shoulder tank would have worked. So, I think that they were playing fair. Yeah, it's just, I mean, to be fair, when I'm playing family, I get accused of, packing and all that kind of thing. When, I see them hiding in the grass, and when, when they're moving, I'm online, and I basically tell them that I saw you move. Yeah, it's a no-win argument. And I'm just like, okay, fair enough. You have your opinion and I have mine. It is what it is. But. Yeah. Like I said. I don't usually go on a rant about these kind of things. It's just, some things on my mind, it really does bother me that the fact that, some people, especially when it comes to, this game, when it comes to playing Survivor, DVD, they just immediately assume, oh, they're hacking. Where's the proof? That's my question, where's the proof? But overall, they played fair, in my opinion. They played fair. I'm not mad. I'm not mad at that, at the previous match. I'm just mad at, the survivor. Who was playing at Azana, because they couldn't go with the fact that, they didn't escape. And they just took it personally. That's the thing these days. People take certain things, whether it's with this game or DVD, way too seriously. They take games way too seriously sometimes, and I'm just like, well, if you're taking it that seriously, why are you playing it? Simple question. Might as well ready up. I will say, moving away from that, I always say, getting three escapes as well, back to back to back, is very rare for me. I don't usually get that often when I'm playing this game. I usually get one escape, then one death after the next. I usually get what happens when I usually play this game in my own time. I get one escape, and then the next match I get one death, and the next game I get one escape, and so forth. It's very rare. that I can get a hat trick, but that's my goal when it comes to recording videos. It's like, make sure I get a hat trick. If I don't get a hat trick, fair enough. It's not on the cards today, but I still have fun playing this game. It gives me a nice little break from playing DVD all the time.
Omar Pauly, native native of Holland, Texas, was arrested in 1967 for aggravated assault and larceny and was sentenced to 5 years in prison. After his release, Omar Pauly was implicated in a string of incidents outside McLennan County, where he was arrested again but managed to escape authorities. His current whereabouts are...
Oh, hello, Anna. Is it near? No, it's in the old room.
Oh, Anna. Like some kind of...
Are you okay?
Oh, I got a level face problem. I think everything is like that, you know, I'm in another escape. Oh. I don't think I'd be able to leave the basement at this point.
Thank you.
No, I'm sure it's in there somewhere. Oh, he got two of them! Oh, the double whammy! Oh, that was funny. Oh boy. I know, right? I've been chased down about a few times.
Seems safe enough. They were here somewhere.
Oh, they got their own payback. GG's. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this video. And with that being said, please leave a like, share, and subscribe for more upcoming TCM and DVD in the future. Bye bye for now.